Good morning, dear children. Welcome to you in today's lecture of English grammar. I hope, dear student, you all are staying safe at home and watching videos regularly. So let me continue the lesson which we have already started in previous lecture. Student, in previous lecture I have given you the homework which is based on the exercise 3. It was the first few examples that was the homework. Now let me see it once again. Now if you have just done that homework, so just cross-check it whether your answers are correct or not, or if any mistakes are there, so just make changes. So let us see that what is the question. Just take out your book and open your book, page number 22. In this sentence, change the subject from singular to plural and plural to singular and rewrite them by making necessary changes in the predicates too. So let us see what we have to do it over here. In a previous exercise was based on the, we have to just form singular singular noun into the plural one. We have to just make changes into singular to plural and plural to singular. Now in this exercise, both we have to just form, or we have to just make changes in both the nouns. Like singular noun is there, so we have to just change into the plural one, and plural noun is there, so we have to just change into the singular one. So let's get started. So first of all, you can see the first one sentence is already solved. The knife cut sharply. The knife cut sharply. Here, knife is a singular noun. Now, when we just change into the plural one, it becomes knives. Now, the next one. There are no mice in these houses. There are no mice in these houses. Now, let me change the sentence into the plural one. There are no mice. Now, let here. Is. So it will be, there is no, again mice, plural noun you can see. Now it will become the singular one, so it is mouse. In these houses. So now let me change it again, so it will be in this house. So what we have done here, the plural noun by teach. Our teacher teaches well. Now, the next one. The book was being packed. The books was being packed. So, just note it down. Just make it complete this sentence in your book. The sixth one is, this bird has its wings broken. Seventh, the goat was accompanied by the shepherd. Eighth, that man is doctor. Ninth, our teacher teaches well. Tenth, the books was being packed. So just make it. Complete this exercise in your book.
Vowel, so just we have just added S to
just make that noun plural one. And if any last word, if last word is y and last letter is y of any word and it is preceded with any consonant, so just removing that y, we have to just add ies in the given word for make that noun plural. And now there are some nouns like ship, deer, dozen, fish. So these nouns have the same form, have the same form for the singular and the plural as well. So just remember, dear student. And the following nouns are always in singular, like furniture, news, scenery. These nouns are always written in the singular form. So this much rule, this rules which is already given is your book page number 19 and 20. It's your work to read that rules once again. Now in this way we have completed this lesson number 3, noun number. And I hope you have understood it very well. So your today's homework is you have to just read the rules, what is given on your book page number 18, 19 and 20, formation of plural, that in what way we can form any singular noun to the plural one. So I hope you have understood. You will do this work. And just sometime you just forget that what is exactly the plural of that word. So list of that noun, singular noun and plural, is already provided for you. Just go through it and learn it. So it will be very easier while you solve any exercise. So I hope you have understood it today's lecture very well. Now let me continue the next lesson in next period. Till then, take care and bye bye.